Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I'm the host and the visionary of the Valder Beebe Show's God Talk. Some people talk to God and others believe that God talks to them. Join us in conversation with authors, religious clergy, metaphysicians, and regular people like you and I and God Talk. God Talk is a podcast available on FM radio, Roku TV, and online. Subscribe at ValderBeebeShow.com. You can also subscribe at youtube.com/ValderBeebeShow. Join the conversation of God Talk. I'll see you there.
Kelly Ryan is head of independent wealth management and she's with State Street Global Advisors. She's here to talk about smart ways to use that tax refund. Kelly, you know, that's a great idea. What can we do to get ahead of the curve? Because the latest research and statistics on the average refund we're receiving as Americans, what do we plan to do with that?
Yeah, so this year, the average American is receiving a refund of just shy of $3,000. And that's a significant amount of money, especially after such a challenging year. The research that we have recently seen says that over half of Americans are planning on either saving or investing their refund.
Ooh, that's a big switch because we're usually talking about buying big ticket items. I like that.
That's right. That's right. Oh,
okay, so we're thinking of savings or investing. How do we take and make a good decision with that?
Yeah, so the first thing we would encourage investors to do is think about, what do you need this money for? If it's a short-term investment, like replenishing your emergency fund, you know, go ahead and put that into your bank account. If it's a longer-term savings goal, like savings for retirement, we think that the market is an interesting place to go. Over the past year or so, the market has performed quite well, and we're really seeing a lot of individuals enter the market for the first time, especially younger individuals who have time on their side.
That was a question I was going to ask. What if you have not been an investor? How do you get into this or trust someone to take you into this?
Yeah, so that's a great question. There are a number of financial advisors and planners out there that will talk to you and walk you through your investment goals. There are also a number of online resources if you prefer to do that research yourself. But a few things that we would ask you to keep in mind. The first is, you know, take costs into consideration, because the higher the cost, the more your returns could potentially erode. This is one of the many reasons why exchange traded funds have become so popular over the past number of years. And just to clarify, exchange traded funds are essentially a basket of securities that trade on the exchange. And that means you can invest in a particular sector of the market, an industry of the market, or even themes that align with your personal interests and beliefs.
You guys did this survey and this research. What else did that yield for us to know?
Yeah, so I think one of the big misconceptions out in the marketplace is that you need a lot of money to invest in the market. And that's just simply not true anymore. You can start by purchasing just a single share of a stock or an exchange traded fund. And some firms nowadays even allow you to buy fractional shares. And so this is really significant. Again, also understanding the fees associated with investing is very important. And you can go to a firm's website like ours, ssga.com, where we list all of the exchange traded funds offered by State Street, as well as the expense ratio or the management fee associated with each fund. The good news for investors is that fees have come down significantly over the years. And we're talking about just a small fraction of a percentage point for a management fee.
Before I wrap up, I'm going to take this post from, which one is this? This is from Instagram. They want to know, they love certain companies and they support those companies. How do they buy stock for those companies? Good question.
It's a great question. So you can either go through a financial advisor or go to an online platform where you can buy and sell stocks or securities. Or if you want to diversify your purchase, and so not just, you know, if we know that healthcare is a very interesting segment of the market, but we're not sure which healthcare company is going to perform the best, we would look at purchasing an exchange traded fund that has exposure to many different companies within the healthcare sector, and therefore diversifying and not having to pick just the winner. You don't have to be an expert stock picker to invest in the market.
Kelly Ryan, that's some great advice. Once again, where does my audience go online so that they can be more informed and more educated in investing?
Sure. Go to ssga.com, where you can find educational information, expense ratios, as well as a tool that can help you select funds that will help you achieve your goals.
Well, I hope my audience feel like I have this morning, Kelly. I feel like I've got a free consultation. Thank you so much for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show.
Thanks for having me. Take care.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television, and this is my phone pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.